Hey, horse people. Well, let's take a look on how not to ride a horse that's bucking and try to give you some tips. There's so many things wrong in here, I'll probably get distracted. But this is kind of what happens. Usually it's the people coaching that tells other people to do stupid things. Normally it's women coaching men and the men are doing the stupid things. And in this case, it looks like a male doing a stupid thing. Stay with him. That's going to leave a mark.
Hold him. Hold him. Hold him. Hold him. Hold him. Hold him. Stay with him.
Okay, so how many things went wrong here? First of all, if the horse is bucking already, probably shouldn't have got on him. They probably said this horse is bucking. Will you ride him? This guy's too big for this horse. Probably causing pain. A lot of big people think if you put a big person on a small horse, it'll stop their bucking. Not so. I'm gonna mute the noise in here so I can kind of watch this. So, if you're going to ride a bucking horse, you want an area with no obstacles, nothing the horse can trip over, that he has to dodge, that will create more fear, bumping, walls, mirrors, all those things inside a horse that's already in fight or flight. When a horse is bucking, their head goes down and normally they're in fight or flight. Either fight or flight for pain, fear, unknown, whatever. This horse is in fight or flight right now. So right here, I don't know if he was gonna bail or was catching his balance. I have gotten off a bucking horse before when he got close to a wall and I was either getting tired or like, okay, he's not calming down. I'm just gonna hop off him here. And sometimes I'm able to get off, sometimes I'm not. So I don't know if he was trying to get off or if he was just gathering his balance. So the one thing he is doing wrong, and I can't tell if this horse has a bit or not, is he's pulling on both reins, which allows the horse to bow and to brace. Which is why I always tell people, ride with one rein first. If your horse bucks and you pull with one rein, you always turn a horse's head, which will stop the bucking, which will create a turning or a circular effect, depending on which way you're running. It will stop him from getting full speed. It will stop him from covering a lot of ground. Much more control with one rein. Anytime a horse bucks with me, I immediately go with one rein, and I only pull on that one rein so it causes his head to turn. This guy didn't know that. Losing his balance right here. I think he has the wrong shoes on. I think the reason why his feet get caught is he's got tennis shoes. And his tennis shoes laces get hooked on the horn here, I believe. Right here. If this wasn't a bit, maybe it is a boot. I don't know what's caught if it's a boot. I'm thinking it's some sort of lace-up that got caught on the horn. And now his laces are caught. So the head kind of bounces here. He may have got kicked in the shoulder here. Now the horse is scared, thinking some predator is attacking and trying to eat his legs. So the horse is in more of a blind panic. And as he crosses this, his head takes a pretty good smash right there. Now, I don't know if it probably knocked him out. That's a pretty good smash. Somebody's going to say if he had a helmet, this would have saved him. He shouldn't have been on the horse. And if he had a helmet, it might have broke his neck. Maybe his head, or the way he was moving, stopped his neck from getting broke. So now he's helpless. I don't know if the horse steps on him here. I can't tell if his hand is actually grabbing the wall here, or if it's just flying because he's unconscious. And the horse is still panicking, and he finally comes unhooked. And I think the video stops. The horse is still bucking. The saddle is kind of gone offside here. And they run in and stop the video. But you see the horse either hitting this bucket or panicking, etc. So, again, because of all this white and blue and balls and things on a wall, when he comes by, he can get caught. His jacket can get caught. He can get pulled. This thing's just set up for this horse to fail. But you know what started? A couple of women said, man, I'm scared of this horse. And I've done it. I've got on horses for a woman. I'm scared, man. Would you ride it? And the horses bucked the shit out of me. And Sometimes I get hurt, sometimes I don't. But I just kind of looked at it as, what the hell? I'll get some bucking experience and get on him. So, this guy, again, you notice the horse's head when he was getting off, he probably stopped pulling on the reins right here. And when he stopped pulling on the reins right here, head goes up. Notice the head's going up because he's leaning this way. The head is being pulled this way. He's probably pulling more on his rein. And it stalled the horse a little bit. You notice the horse stalls right here. His head is up. He's running instead of bucking. And then after the guy grabs the horn, the horse starts bracing and bucking again. Head goes down. Head goes down. Guy's pulling on both reins, helping the horse brace. He ought to have his feet out of the stirrups here. He doesn't. So this foot is still in a stirrup. Now he's leaning. Now he can't pull this foot out of the stirrup because all his weight is on this. So when he falls, his boot or tennis shoe or sole gets caught in here, which is why I have a special pair of boots when I'm riding that are a little bit bigger. And they're pointed toes, and they're a little bit bigger than my normal boots. And my foot slips out of the boot completely. Lace-up boots, very bad when you're riding horses because your foot can't slip out. Any shoe you're riding, you ought to be able to slip your foot out. Very easy. I wear an oversized boot when I'm riding for this very reason, that if I fall, my foot's coming out of my boot. And if the horse wants to run off of my boot, well, knock yourself out. Really, really sad situation here.
Stay with them.
Stay with them.
Hold him,
hold him, hold him, hold him, hold him. Really? I want you to look at this horse right here when his head hits. There's a horse in the stall like, hey, what's going on? Check it out. Some dumbass has jumped on this horse. He's trying to get him off. I wonder what's happening. Watch this horse when his head hits his stall. He's like, boom. The horse is like, what the? Now the horse is spooked, scared, runs out, probably got hurt. Horse probably jumped the fence, got hurt. Another horse got hurt because of this. Just a freaking disaster. So, anyway, I don't know what I should call this. How to fail. How to set a horse up to fail. How to plan or not have a plan. Remember, not having a plan is a plan to fail. I'm thinking there wasn't a very good plan here. All right. Lots of things to learn from this. All right, we'll end out there. Y'all have a good one. This little horsey did nothing wrong. This is not the horse's fault. It wasn't prepared properly. It wasn't set up for success. It wasn't lunge. It wasn't turned out except weight. The guy's too big. All kind of things set this horse up to fail, and the horse went exactly where the human led it, to failure. This is not a horse problem. This is a people problem. We'll end out there.